Hello guys and welcome back for a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can leave some comments in the comment section down below. And don't forget to press the like button if you've enjoyed this content. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at a pair of running shoes from Adidas, which they are meant to be used for short to mid runs. So let's go ahead and take them out of the box, guys. Okay guys, so in today's video we're gonna have a look at the Adidas X9000 L4. So this one, it's actually not a brand new release. It was released, if I'm not mistaken, around 5 to 6 weeks ago. And this one got released in this color combination about 2 to 3 weeks ago. It's here in the UK for a retail price of £120. And this is just one out of those 7 color combinations which they are still available on the Adidas website. So this one, guys, as you can see, has a full length Boost midsole, which is actually a cheaper alternative to the Ultra Boost 21. And of course, this one will be made with some prime green materials, meaning that 50% of the upper of the shoe is made with recycled content, and we are not having any virgin polyester whatsoever on this one, guys. And we know that Adidas is using this prime green alongside the Parley in a lot of their shoes. So let's go ahead and do a breakdown of this shoe, guys. As you can see, for most of the upper we're gonna have this knit material, which has a very nice pattern, and we're also gonna have this translucent details. Going to the actual lacing system, you can see that we have some punch out holes. We're also gonna have some loop style material as well, and at the top we're gonna have a different one, so this one looks actually quite nice in my opinion. Of course, for the actual laces we're gonna have this rope style one in this black color, and just underneath these laces we're gonna have a very well padded tongue in this black color, which also has this Adidas logo in this translucent green. As we get to the actual midfoot of the shoe, you can see that we're gonna have these three stripes in this rubberized material, which depending how the light it's hitting these stripes, we're gonna have a different color on them. Just beneath these stripes we're gonna have this rubberized material, which acts like a small mudguard in this black color. And as you get at the heel section, you can see that we have this green color heel support, which also has written here on the lateral side X9000 L4. So this one really looks like an actual extent of this Boost midsole, which in my opinion actually looks very nice and very aggressive. And as we go inside, guys, we're gonna have a black lining, which also has a very good amount of padding, and I felt that this one is keeping my foot in place very nicely. Also, we're gonna have this rubber insole in this green color, which it's actually a bit heavy in my opinion. I'm not entirely sure why they decided to put this heavy and thick insole when we actually have this Boost midsole. So in my opinion, they should have just put one like the Ultra Boost 21, which is slightly a bit thinner and not so heavy. And of course we're gonna have written here in black prime green. And now we can go to this Boost midsole, which as you can see, it has a very aggressive look. In my opinion, it looks slightly a bit with the Easy 500, which I actually have here, so it's not gonna be completely the same, but as you can see, the similarities are actually there. This one of course will have some more straight lines than the Easy 500, which is actually a bit more rounder. Of course on the medial side we're gonna have written here Jet Boost in this black color. And now we're gonna finish with this rubber outsole, which as you can see it has a very grippy traction and it looks again very aggressive. You can see that we're gonna have three colors for this actual rubber outsole, being this green, black and gray. And of course we're also gonna have this Boost midsole exposed in few places. And also here at the heel section we have Adiwear written. As in for the actual sizing guys, on the Adidas website they are recommending to go with a full size up, which in my opinion it's actually a good suggestion if you have normal and wider feet. But if you have a skinny feet like me, I think that just half size up will be just fine. So overall guys, my impression on this X9000L4 is that they actually have quite good materials, and having this Boost midsole for sure is gonna make this shoe actually very comfortable and very good. And given that this whole midsole is actually very wide comparing with the actual shoe, as you can see here, for sure you're gonna have actually a very good support overall. And this mesh material, even though it's not the one like the Ultra Boost 21, it's actually quite breathable and stretchable enough in my opinion. And of course if you don't like this specific colorway, you can choose from those seven available now on the Adidas website. So yeah guys, this was my unboxing and review of this Adidas X9000L4. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.